water levels. They're responsible for some of the highest stress levels in any game. Maybe it's because of the gravy controls. Maybe it's the nonsense puzzles. Maybe it's the terrifying creatures of the deep. Or maybe it's the ticking clock, counting down our very ability to breathe, giving us that feeling of impending and imminent doom. Nevertheless, the music in water stages tends to be some of the more relaxing tracks we hear in video games, seemingly contradictory to the level of anxiety that most of us feel when going through them. Let's look at how Nintendo's Poster Boy has handled this over the years, starting with where it all began. The first water level in a Mario game came in World 2 Level 2 of Super Mario Bros. On the NES, and it's accompanied by a lilting waltz track. Koji Kondo designed the music specifically to reflect the player's physical experience of playing the game. In contrast to the above world theme, which is pretty bouncy like Mario, the water music is more fluid. The player's physical experience in these levels is dampened somewhat, for better or for worse, by the mechanics of being in water. Mario moves slower at first, then accelerates as his movement continues, flowing both up and down as well as left and right. This ebb and flow sense of movement is captured by the quick three feeling of the waltz. We feel weight on the first beat of each measure and float away on the second and third beats. The theme itself is 32 bars long, including a 4-bar introduction. Following the introduction, it comprises 4 phrases. The first and second phrase are each 8 measures long, and the third is made up of 2 shorter 4-bar sub-phrases. We would expect the last phrase to return to 8 measures, which would form what's known as a musical sentence, but it's cut short after only 4 measures, making instead an abbreviated sentence. Since the 4-measure introduction is also included in the repeated loop, it's very possible that cutting the final phrase short was as much a result of technological limitations as it was a musical intention. The melody in the first phrase stays close to the 1 chord in C major, ornamenting it with a lowered chromatic neighbor first, and then with an upper neighbor. The second phrase follows suit, but this time is based on the dominant 7th chord. The first 2 phrases are closely related, with the second imitating the pattern of the first a step lower. The third phrase sequences down a step over a descending bass line, and the final phrase cadences quickly back on C major before looping back to do it all again. If the waltz of Super Mario Bros. Captured the physical experience of the water level with a quick 3 feel, the water music of Super Mario Bros. 3 had a slightly different idea of what lilting would be. Koji Kondo reportedly had a hard time with the soundtrack to this game, unsure how to follow up on the previous game's music. The water theme we got still captures the physical experience of swimming, but this time through the use of syncopation. The tune rises and falls quickly in the first half of each measure, but then seems to get hung up on syncopated patterns in the second half. The rapid ascent and descent, followed by the suspended feeling in the syncopation, seems to mirror the way Mario moves when the player pushes the swim button. Thanks to user Velhart on Super Mario Maker, we can see this in a very literal way. We'll be right back. At only 12 bars long, this track is much shorter than the first water theme, and also much simpler. It is made up of only 3 4 measure phrases, and the first two are identical, forming an AAB structure. The A phrase is characterized by a rush through the tonic arpeggio, either up or down, followed by syncopated chromatic neighbors. The effect of this rhythm is a feeling of pushing and pulling the tempo in each measure, and it would perhaps obscure the beat if it wasn't for the extremely regular rhythm of the accompaniment. The first water tune relied primarily on melody, while the second relied primarily on rhythm. The NES did not allow for many options, having only 5 channels for music, with 1 doubling up for the game sounds as well. By the time the Nintendo 64 came along, there were many more options. The N64 had no dedicated sound chip, instead running sound through the CPU itself. This allowed the 16-bit audio to be mixed using, theoretically, up to 100 channels, although most games used between 16 and 24. With this development in technology, composers had also begun to realize that certain effects could be used to create ambience as well. The question became not so much, what does swimming underwater feel like, but more, what does swimming underwater sound like? There are 2 water levels in Super Mario 64, both using the track titled Dire Dire Docks. Featuring a distinctly video game-esque synth keyboard, the song incorporates aspects of both of the earlier tracks. The rhythmic shape of the Super Mario Bros. 3 track is retained, with this rush through the first half of the measure followed by slowing down towards the end of the measure. This creates the feeling of flow, like the pull of a tide, in each phrase. The shape of the melody creates an arc, swelling up and floating down. This melodic shape, paired with the ebb and flow of the rhythm, evokes the idea of a rolling ocean, or bobbing up and down in a lake or a river. What sets this track apart from the earlier tracks, though, is the effects put on the music. The keyboard is recorded with heavy reverb. This serves first to soften the onset of each attack by blurring it into the note that came before, muting the previous crispness of the 8-bit style and making it sound more like we would expect things to sound underwater, more muffled. The other effect the reverb has is to create an environment with an echo. Obviously, we cannot hear sound echoing underwater. Even though sound waves travel much faster through water than through the air, they do not vibrate the ossicle bones in the ear, which allow us to perceive it. However, both of these levels have specific areas that are enclosed, and the music enhances this feeling of spelunking through the use of reverb. The exact rhythm of the arpeggiated accompaniment changes from measure to measure, sometimes more and sometimes less active. For me, this reminds me of something like a coral reef, something beautiful where the overall scenery doesn't change, but the closer you look, the more you notice all the tiny creatures darting around. Maybe it makes you picture something else. When the synth strings enter, it really drives home the idea of being in water. Long notes, feeling like it's almost moving in slow motion, and elegantly flowing over the rising and falling melody. As the Mario series progressed and technology continued to develop, the music for these water levels continued to evolve. They always feature some type of ambient effect to reinforce the image of being in water, though, which, at least as far as Mario is concerned, can be traced right back to Dire Dire Docks. Whether you love them or hate them, almost every game has some sort of water level, and the composer always sets aside special music for it. Perhaps the reason that a lot of this music feels calming is because the developers realize that it is the most anxiety-inducing moment of every game. What other water levels stick out in your mind? Did this video help you understand why that music fits where it does? If so, I hope you'll subscribe for more videos like this one. Don't forget to like this video and comment below if there's some water music you'd like to hear more about, and I will see you in the next video.